Hello, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. I have an incredibly helpful video for you today. It's directed at all guitar players so that you guys can learn the sound and note layout on the neck of the most important color tones of the major and minor scales, along with a couple of popular modes. And this work will train your ear, it'll help you better understand notes and intervals on the neck, and you'll be able to fully understand the effects of musical sound. To achieve perfect guitar playing, you have to have an understanding of how scales operate, what they do, and especially what the emotional effect is that they produce. For most students who are practicing guitar, the major or minor scale is a scale in name only. For new students of scales and music theory, there's generally no complete high-level understanding of why one scale might be used in a song over another. And also, after today's video, what's going to happen is you'll have an understanding of what each scale does and why we call them major and minor, but you'll also better comprehend the most important part of learning scales, and that's the emotional effect they can produce in music. Let me show you exactly what I mean. The tones of the basic major scale that we're going to focus on are going to be the core tones of the root, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and the octave. Now, across the notes of a key, we have certain degrees, scale tones, that together end up producing the scale's tonality. In a basic major scale, the interaction of the scale's root note, the tonic or naming note of the scale, along with the fourth and fifth, plus the relationship, of course, to the third and the sixth, produces the scale's tonality. Now, it is important to remember to mention the seventh. It's what we call in theory the leading tone. It's right in behind the root. So the seventh does play a role for sure, but you know, it can get altered, and it happens while maintaining the major color. Really, the primary tone that's the color defining tone that we have is definitely the third. You know, that's what generates the color of the chord that's off the root step of the scale, and it's really what brings together the sound. And you can tell this when I play the tones isolated. You know, we really get that major effect. But if you play, you know, the major sound through off of these core tones of root, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and octave, you can tell it produces a very, you know, happy, uplifting, triumphant sound. And one of the things you want to do once you get a organization of notes together is transfer it to someplace else on the neck. So let's do that next. I'm going to take this A note up an octave here on the 12th fret of the 5th string, and we'll just recreate those notes again. The root, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and the octave. You can tell, you know, again, that happy, uplifting, triumphant sound. You can hear the triad is in there too. It's a very strong effect. When we study music and music theory, we find out that a scale's third is the tonal defining note. So if it's a major third, it's a major scale. If it's a minor third, it's a minor scale. Another note that's important in a scale is the sixth degree. If it's a major six, you're in a major scale. If it's a minor six, you're in a minor scale. But the seventh also plays a role. Only thing is, when we get into minor forms, we'll find major seven and minor seven as a part of those different forms for natural minor and harmonic minor. So it can get a little bit confusing in that realm. Really, in the basic major scale, the best thing to do is spot the third and the sixth tones. We'll call them major third, major six, because they operate in combination with the scale's fourth and fifth, as well as with the scale's naming note, the tonic or the root, to form the entire tonal response, which also creates a sound effect that we call in music the emotional effect. Now, when we go to minor, it's a little bit different sound that you're going to notice right away will be a different impact as compared to major. So next, let me show you how all this works in the minor scale. The natural minor scale's core tones are going to be very similar to what we covered in major, except this time the third and the sixth will have dropped. So we'll have the root note or the tonic naming note of the scale and the key, and then we'll move up into minor third, perfect fourth, perfect fifth, minor sixth, and the octave. You can tell it's a little bit different color, it's darker. Now, Now that's the natural minor scale setup with that lowered third. And something else to keep in mind is the seventh degree is also really an interesting color in this sound. You know, just the fact though that it can be restructured and you can create scales like harmonic and melodic minor as alternate forms of the minor scale. It's just, you know, you want to focus on what really brings about the core color. So we look towards the chord itself and then the uniqueness of the sixth tone. That really gives you a lot of the effect. It's strong, you know, again, we're looking for that sound too, and understanding how we can arrange and compose with this scale type and really tell the effect of the darker, kind of sad, negative sound as compared to what we heard with our sound of the major scale, which was a little bit more lighter and uplifting. So the minor tones, once again, you know, we laid them out here in the low register. Let's take them up an octave and do them up here as well. Tell the upper octave register is same layout, root, minor third, perfect fourth, perfect fifth, minor sixth. And hear the arpeggio in there as well. But it's just, you know, understanding the color changes that happen, the third and the sixth dropping down half step. I still have a few more of these ideas I want to go over with you, but I also wanted to just take a minute to let you know that if you need to learn more about the basics, you know, keys and harmony and bar chords, stuff like that, then I'm going to make you a great offer. With any donation over $5 or any merchandise purchase from my Teespring store or anything from the website, I'll send you a free collection of some of my most popular digital handouts. One is called Harmonized Arpeggio Drills, and it's going to train you on developing your diatonic arpeggios. Some excellent work there. Also, another one is my bar chord and keys handout. That's a great handout. It includes a page showing all the key signatures along with how to understand them and a chord progression that also applies bar chords. Plus, you'll also get my notation pack. It has 8 pages of blank guitar worksheets for notating anything you're going to be doing related to guitar, you know, music charts, guitar chord diagrams, tab, all that stuff. Plus, there's going to be some bonus handouts in there as well. And what I want you to do is after you make your donation or merchandise purchase, just send me an email, let me know what you did there, and I will email you those digital handouts within 24 hours. Well, as you just saw and you heard, the minor scales, lower third and sixth degrees, work together to create the minor tonality. And these tones are called minor third and minor sixth, and they produce the minor sound in combination with the natural minor scale's fourth and fifth steps, as well as that scale's naming note, the tonic or root note, all coming together to form the tonal response or the emotional effect of that scale. It's really simplistic, but the impact is very, very strong. So it's excellent to know this information because it really helps you target sound. Now, the next thing I want to do is help you find out what happens with two popular modes. We're going to look at the Mixolydian mode and the Dorian mode and find out just exactly what happens with these thirds and sixes and even also the seventh when we check out these different modes. For heading into the modal direction, the first scale that we're going to be looking at is Mixolydian, and we're going to look at its core tones as being the flat 7, the major 3rd, and then having the 4th and 5th, just like we had seen with the major and minor. The reason why we decided to go with flat 7 there is the flat 7 is a very unique tone in building the color of Mixolydian. Now, that's not to say that the major 6 still doesn't play a role. It does still offer us some very nice sound, but the unique flavor of what happens when we generate Mixolydian, let's say from a major scale, is that we lower the seventh degree while maintaining the major third. So those two notes, they really bring about a shift in the color. So if you take the seventh down and maintain a major third, that's the effect of the Mixolydian. And just keep that in mind, that the seventh note of the scale goes down a half step, mixing a major third sound against that minor seven. This is what creates that interesting blend that's really fantastic for styles that don't fall into the conventional sounds like basic major and minor. So I'm talking about styles like blues, soul music, funk, R&B, Motown, as well as jazz and jazz fusion music. In fact, the way that we cover all of our non-functioning dominant seventh chords in jazz is we use the Mixolydian mode. It's one of the options anyway. All right, nice sound. Now let's take a look at Dorian mode next. Dorian mode is going to drop the third tone down so we can create our minor third sound. But what the really unique effect here is actually based all around the sixth degree. So what we're going to have against that minor third is we're going to have a major six. So we have root, minor third, perfect, fourth, perfect, fifth, but then major six. And of course, if you are going to think about the seven, you know, I haven't been focusing a lot on the seventh quality through all of this, except for Mixolydian. But if you did think in terms of the seventh coming in, it would be a whole step away from that root. We're building these off of the root of A for the most part in all these exercises. So this would, you know, bring us around with a G natural. So similar to Mixolydian, but the unique aspect is the minor third. Right, so Dorian mode, like I said, dropping that minor third down a half step, creating that minor third sound, and you know, really giving us a unique sound quality based around major six being there alongside of that. So that tonal response that we have in these core tones that's going to give us our perfect sound is a blend of the minor third against the major six. If you really want to perfect your musical sound, the thing that's important to understand is that scales create an emotional effect that's not just tied to music theory or the way that the scale makes us feel when we play through it. There's another level of work here, and it has to do with the way that our emotions are affected by the sound, and also how that sound is directly tied to a specific musical style. So the scales we choose, combined with the knowledge of the scale's emotional effect, will help us as musicians to be able to decide the emotional direction of the state of mind that we're hoping for in the person who's listening to our music. And once we fully comprehend how all this happens, we will truly perfect our ability to control sound, have a style that we use when we write music, and also how we compose and arrange music for others to enjoy. Guys, if you want to get a more detailed breakdown of all this information, including the diagrams and tab for each idea I went over, then head down to my blogger page at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and a thumbs up below. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.